close to the vest. Nobody talked about where their advantages were at before the game and what we're going to be looking for. So nobody gave away anything, where last week they gave away everything. And we all knew exactly what these teams are thinking.
Full day of coverage right here on the SEC Network. Monday starting Eastern with SEC.
Georgia, TCU?
Georgia.
Georgia.
In a landslide.
I mean, you know where you're at.
Put the house on it, Alyssa.
Stetson Bennett, walk-on, also junior college player. I was a walk-on and also. Stetson might be your age at this point, speaking of. Ouch. He's been there a long time. I'm not calling you.
It's going to be a long night.
Still with 5 points, which he got all of them in the first quarter. And then a travel is called on Will Jamison there.
And now this is a big possession coming up for the Warriors. You just got to turn over there. Really need to come away with some points right here.
And one thing they also should try to avoid is another minute-long possession. As their last two possessions almost amounted to 3 minutes in that third quarter.
And you especially don't want to have those types of possessions if you're not coming away with points.
And now Jameson with a steal and the bucket. Lead now up to 11. The Warriors really going to have to start picking up the pace here.
And that bucket from Will Jameson right there was his first point since the first quarter. As you get another look at it right there, he tried to draw a little bit of contact as he's going up to the hoop. Didn't get the call, but still got the bucket.
As we're going to get a timeout here from the Homestead Spartans, as they currently lead this one 35-24. They have just been in control of this one overall. We did see the Warriors come out early on in that third quarter, go on a big run. But since then, the Homestead Spartans have really silenced that.
Yeah, and a big part of that is this Spartans team has so much depth on their roster. If a couple players are struggling, they're able to make substitutions and get some other big names into the game.
So now with 7:18 remaining in this ball game, the Warriors have got to get it going offensively. As it will be Spartans ball.
And you mentioned a few moments ago how the Warriors do not want to have
now it's going to be Miles Everingham. Over to Zbarth. And then a foul will be called on Jameson. Jameson picked up two fouls early on in this one. And now here in the fourth
had five steals in that game. They go with 10 points.
Auburn is going to get good looks on that ball screen when there's no help defense. Arkansas has to fight over the top and not let the point guard or the wing player get to that screen.
Here's Green. And nobody there to put it in. Chris Moore with the putback. Hogs 3-for-3 to start the game. Walsh trying to shake. Got Broom off of him. And it got collided by Moore. And it'll be the first on Auburn's Chris Moore.
You got to be one and done on the defensive end if you're Auburn. They are okay with Arkansas getting the ball in the middle of that zone. They're not denying that, but they got to play man-to-man, box out after the miss.
Thank you. Kamani Jensen replaced Devo Davis a moment ago. And Kamani Johnson wasting no time. Tip it in. Loose ball. Hogs find it. It's Walsh again. And the lid's still on it. And then a jump ball on the takedown. It will stay with Arkansas. 11-7. And we got a shootout, perhaps. Both coaches still have their shirts on for now.
Fitness starts from the inside out. Get healthy, real hydration.
Well, they're both closed right now, but there doesn't seem to be any love lost
to cover, especially in shoot-arounds. There is no stone unturned in their scattered reports in their film.
Council trying to find some space against Dylan Cardwell to put some size on him now. Auburn has played primarily zone tonight. Walsh banks it in.
Great one at the push off there. Walsh had that forearm out, did a good job not extending it too far. No call by the refs.
That ends a skid of five consecutive misses by Arkansas after they couldn't get any of those putbacks to go.
You'll see Walsh here go baseline. And Wendell Green kind of starts backpedaling with him. Just a little bit of a push there, but no call. Wendell Green is red hot from three, but one of the most important things he's got to do for Auburn tonight is take care of the basketball. They turn it over a little bit too much. That's a great pass play there. And Arkansas thrives on black ball turnovers.
Getting Flanagan involved. He had 6-4 in this game last year. He's coming off of 11 points in a disappointing loss on the road to Mike White's Georgia team. Georgia held Auburn to just 64 points. Nice cut by Black, and in traffic, took a bump. May have taken a shot across the nose. Jalen Williams picks up the foul.
Tom, that easy basket for a guy like Flanagan might look like just an easy 2 points, but streaky type play. player like him, the first one to go in, usually can lead to better things from the perimeter as well.
So Anthony Black to the free throw line, 70% on the season. McDonald's All-American, rated the number card of the country coming in to Fayetteville, and he gets the first to go. Mentioned the name Nick Smith, a freshman out of North Little Rock High School, is not with the team right now. He is rehabbing back in Southern California. He's a client of Clutch Sports, and so they're keeping a close eye on him. It remains to be seen when or if he'll return to this Arkansas team. Very few programs can lose a talent like Nick Smith and still hold on to their trajectory, but it seems like Eric Musselman's squad is in good shape to do just that.
Yeah, they're carrying along with their business like pros, and they have other talented players out there. And don't forget, I would argue the loss of Trevor Brazil might be even more replaceable, the stretch five-man supreme athlete who's out with a torn ACL.
Yeah, Brazil will not return for the rest of the season, the transfer from Missouri. And they're going with Mitchell inside. He's been great defensively, an Arkansas turnover. Here's KD Johnson. Back to Flanagan trailing. Got it! Alan Flanagan. Couple of buckets early. Auburn by six.
And the bad news for Arkansas is the streaky players for Auburn are on a hot streak right now early.
And you said that baseline out of bounds could be simple enough to get a good player playing better. Wing three off the back rim. Black off the mark. Here's Johnson. He can be streaky. This entire Auburn backcourt can catch fire in a hot minute. They just hadn't shown it in SEC play coming in. When you look at what these coaches have built in their time on the respective prices, no roster turnover unforeseen in college basketball, at least pre-transfer portal. Back-to-back Elite Eights for the first time since the mid-90s. And this Arkansas program, I don't know what those two guys are doing, but this Arkansas program, Dane, has been sensational. Most wins among SEC teams since 2019. These two are 1-2.
And those top two teams there have really carried the SEC brand through March Madness. But to me, that graphic just illustrates the parity in the SEC. When the SEC Network first launched, there were two teams covered, Kentucky, Florida.
Team lead and Wendell Green Jr. going to the free throw line. Green had 19 in this game last year. Had 5 assists and a couple of steals. And Pearl was just raving about him in that performance when we talked with the Auburn head coach before the game today.
He's the most valuable player for this Auburn team. If he's playing bad, Auburn's playing bad. If he's playing average, Auburn's likely playing average. And if he's playing great, well, you see what's happening. And he is the key to Auburn remaining a top 25 team.
1-2 from the line, rebound by Kamani Johnson. Anthony Black, 6'7", runs the point for Arkansas. One of the reasons there's about 30 scouts in attendance tonight. Joseph Pinion was fantastic off the bench for the Hogs. They're trying to run a play for him, but it's picked off out front. And now Brown with the finish.
Auburn had been in zone almost the entire game. Pinion comes in, they recognize the shooter and say, hey, let's switch it man-to-man. Disrupts Arkansas offensively.
Pinion with 3 of 6 from deep against Missouri, but his first bucket came on ball pullback.
And now they switch back to zone. Got to keep your eye on 5 and 0. That's the two shooters for Arkansas.
Hogs trying to work into the baseline and off of Mikel Mitchell's hands. His twin brother, Makai, will check in and replace him at the 5 spot.
Well, that's just great off-ball defense there by Wendell Green. And a good job of being patient. Black was ready to deflect that skip-ahead pass. Wendell Green took that extra dribble to make the safe one.
8 points off turnovers for Auburn here early on.
And that was really the storyline where you felt like
and Donaldson, his first. A double-digit lead mentioned a moment ago, though, that Arkansas has been fantastic when they get down. They just have so much firepower. Fourth in the SEC at 77 points a game. And Walsh 1-2.
And as Coach Musselman said to the media earlier this week, he said, I'd rather be bad in the first half, good in the second, and vice versa. But that's exactly who they've been in this season. So Auburn can't assume that they've seen the best effort Arkansas has so far in this game.
They were fantastic in the second half against Missouri. The jumpers off the mark.
Great box out by Mitchell. You were talking about him earlier. I think he's one of the most underrated big men in the entire conference. Does all the little things for the Razorbacks.
Mitchell, first, second half against Missouri, 36% shooting in the first half, 62% in the second half. That, of course, was a home game run. It's stripped by Katie Johnson. Hawks will have 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Just great pride in your one-on-one defensive assignment by KD Johnson. Auburn wants to show help. They want to be in the gaps. But KD Johnson says, I don't need help. I got mine. Good call. By zero.
Black finds Mitchell. That's a high percentage look.
And you felt like Broome came over a little bit too early. I'll be late on that help because they don't want to give up the backside rebound, says Bruce Pearl in the film room.
Broome got doubled. Georgia did a great job doubling him, especially early in that game. And it'll be Arkansas basketball, the chagrin of the students behind us. They've shown up in full force, even though classes don't resume here for another week.
How many of them think have New Year's resolutions?
Got caught in traffic and picks up his second. And so one of the Hawks. That's something that probably decided this game because Arkansas is a really good defensive rebounding team, leading the SEC at 77%. Dana Williams has earned another. And a season high 14 off the bench against Florida. Gives him 10 points, 5.5 boards a game. And the 70% shooter knocks them both down. Largest lead in this first half is 10. Here's Mekhi Mitchell working on Broom and Walk with it.
That was perfect zone defense by Auburn. They recognized where the shooters were, and they allowed the ball to go in the post, and they pretty much manned up from there, played one-on-one down low.
Been 2 minutes and 44 seconds since Auburn made a bucket. And a foul 30 feet from the basket of Kamani Johnson, who's saying, hey, he's got a hold of my jersey. He's pulling. And gets in it with Katie Johnson walking off the floor. Katie Johnson not afraid to share his opinion.
Eat like a king who's on a budget. Three tasty options, fries, drink, and nuggets. All for $5. Wait, that can't be right. Just confirm that that's the real price.
BK. Have it your way.
When I was younger, I played make-believe. Now when I close my eyes, I just fall asleep. Dream on, dream on. To infinity. Dream on.
Take a picture.
I'm stuck! Is that a new iPhone?
Yep, I just got the new iPhone 14 with its amazing camera at T-Mobile.
Wow!
For a limited time at T-Mobile, get four iPhone 14s on us and four new lines for $25 a line.
I'll remember that life forever. We laughed. We cried. We protected Progressive Home and Auto Bundle day and night. We were all of us dazzling. Like knights sworn to protect our kingdom. We knew it wouldn't last forever, but that's what made it special.
I know we'll be back tomorrow, right?
Yeah, but it'll never be today again.
Just get on the bus!
Mornings made easy. That's totally Target.
There's no question Katie Johnson is an emotional player, and he at times can be the engine for this Auburn team. Watch Zero right on the logo getting into Kamani Johnson and words exchange. Terry Oglesby having to celebrate him, separate him. Eric Musselman ran out to have a word with the officials. And you consider the history of this series, Dane, it's no surprise that we'd have some chippiness.
Absolutely. It's become a little bit of a rivalry because of the close games that they've had. You see three of four decided by 4 points or fewer. Two in overtime. And look, I had a lot of players for Arkansas that weren't on the team last year, but there's a lot of guys for Auburn that were on the team last year. when they had the court storming in Fayetteville, and they remember exactly what's at stake.
That ended a 19-game Auburn win streak. Hogs have won three straight in this series. Jalen Williams swishes the first. He's got another coming. Jalen Graham checks in for Arkansas for the first time as Kamani Johnson sits with two. Four early for Williams.
We questioned if Auburn would press at all because the tempo can at times favor Arkansas. I think they've done a good job extending pressure without making it go 94 feet just to slow them down.
Walsh over the zone couldn't hit, but the newcomer pulls it down. That's Jalen Graham, senior out of Phoenix. And then a foul inside. We put Kai Mitchell at the free throw line.
I think Bruce Pearl's going to address with his team, hey, our first shot defense has been pretty good. It's been the second chance opportunities that we've given Arkansas, despite the Razorbacks not making the Tigers pay too much, just two second chance points.
Kai Mitchell has been a defensive standout for Arkansas the last couple of games, especially. In fact, the last eight, he's averaging two blocks a game. Transfer originally from Maryland. He and his twin, Mikel, then went to Rhode Island before settling in Northwest Arkansas. Mikel is the older of the twins. Beat his brother by 2 minutes.
to get that little jump shot.
Yeah, Justice is taking 130. Reset it. Stewart running the baseline. Bediako.
Since they're going to take away your strength, the three-point shot, you got to make them pay.
Justice now with four. Timmy inside again, off balance. He's going to have to earn them again tonight, gentlemen. Pretty obvious. And wide open underneath. Watson went for the deflection ball. Ended up with Jaden Bediako. 12-8 Santa Clara. Bediako's first field goal. Julian Strother beyond the free throw line is off. Miss cleared by Parker Brown. Stewart down the lane. There's the whistle. And this is on Hickman, I believe. And if it is, that's number two on Nolan Hickman. Santa Clara off to a start. Keyshawn Justice with four. The Broncos up by four.
Life is uncertain. Everyday pressures can feel overwhelming. It's okay to feel stressed, anxious, worried, or need when you need it the most. Call our warm line at 833-317-4673 or live chat at calhope.org today.
With Prime Video, explore glow-ups, breakups, and mess-ups.
Do you think this is funny?
Stream live sports, watch, rent, and buy additional movies, and even add on other streamers like Discovery Plus. So much to love in one app.
Wow.
See where it takes you. Prime Video.
If you've ever raised your hand, you know it takes courage. The courage to risk everything. To offer help. To go first. The courage to reach for the stars. But imagine how much easier it will be to raise your hand. With the confidence of a Gonzaga degree.
And welcome back to the Levy Center in Santa Clara,
Hey, credit Julius Strother on that double team. There's